First, I tender my apology being late, but something, everything is not under the control despite very good planning. I feel very sorry before this august audience. Excellency, former governor of Delhi, Mr. Khanna, Mahavir Prasad, who is the patron of this very program, esteemed Dr. Manjeet Kaur Makka, who is the guest of honor, along with this other dignitaries decorating the dais, along with this worthy audience. This program is organized to honor those women who have achieved something in the shape of the distinction, and for them, award ceremony is being organized. At the outset, I would like to speak on the issue of women, their status in historical perspective, and how they were denied, they were neglected, they were rather rejected, and even sometimes the history of feminist movement is proving this very fact, that women, they were not treated equal to the men. That is a sorry matter. Even I am talking, focusing those countries who are having now championing the cause of the human rights, particularly USA, London, that is UK, and what to talk about the Muslim countries where still women, they are fighting for their due rights and due place, they have not been able to get today. But time is changing. History is trying to improve, to get the catch up of the modernity, principle of equality, gender justice issue, and along with this no discrimination on the basis of sex, that is proclaiming of the Constitution of India, that is the supreme law of the land. Women troubled and troubled, is struggling for their due place. And I may tell you, even the country which are living in terms of the civilization today, women, they were denied the voting rights. Women, they were denied the professional education. Women, they have not been treated to be the part of the person, and person was standing for the he means male. That was the situation. But time is changing now. Women, they are getting their due place, and I'm sure they will be arising, and they have arisen already, and they have got their rights recognized. And now, the government, laws, everybody, and rather, statutory provisions, they are caring for the youth. I would like to speak, even just, I have been already spoken by the organizer, their time is very short. But I was having full length speech on this very issue, but I will be cutting short, and just only you give me 3 minutes time if Mahavir Sahib, this is possible. Even I am talking in our Indian context particularly, and that is not far away. Even Baba Sahib Ambedkar, when he wrote this Hindu Court Bill on the encouragement of Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, and there he tried to give the due place to the women, and Women Causes Act of England, that was borrowed by him. He searched and searched the religious literature, and ultimately he prepared the Hindu Court Bill. And in Hindu Court Bill, an effort was made for giving the due place to the women, especially Hindus. And when this bill was presented in the parliament, even that bill was unconventionally opposed by the first president of India, because the situation was not ripe at that time, and people, they were thinking after the getting freedom, Hindu religiosity, Hindu scriptures, that will be getting due appreciation, rather denying those Hindu literature's prescription regarding the women. Now the advanced enactment is educated in the parliament that is not parliament. And ultimately, that bill was pushed back, and Dr. Ambedkar, being the first law minister, he resigned from the law ministership, and he said to Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru that you gave me a promise for doing something very concrete for the betterment of Indian society, and even my bill which I proposed, that was rejected. I am talking about India, and there he was talking that Hindu women, they should come up and they should get that right for which Indian constitution stands, and that is no discrimination on the basis of sex. And after that, that was a great setback. He was struggling and struggling. After just 4 and 5 years, a prime change and paradigm change that took place, and ultimately Hindu Marriage Act 1955, Hindu Succession Act 1956, Hindu Adoption Act came into being, and along with this Hindu Guardianship Act also came into being. And by that, women's position was much elevated. They got the right of the divorce, grounds where they are given. Earlier, once marriage, always marriage. Whether marriage was for your refuge, marriage was for denial of your right, marriage was meant at that time superiority of the men. Concept Ardhangini, yet she was having no right for exercising in the area of matrimonial laws. In the area of adoption, in the area of divorce, in the area of property matters, everywhere. But a very good elevation came into being by all these 4 narratives. So it means gradually we are improving for. Even you talk about the Muslim women, at that time their situation was like that. Muslim women under any situation having no right for the dissolution of the marriage whatsoever may be the reason. But people worked hard. Dissolution of Muslim Marriage Act 1939 came into being. 9 grounds they were given there, and by which Muslim women got entitlement to knock the door of the judiciary for the purpose of the dissolution of marriage. And even I am talking about the Parsis. Parsis, they got their Marriage and Divorce Act 1936, and there almost struggling, and then they followed Hindu Marriage Act 1955, and accordingly they made the drastic amendment in their matrimonial laws, and Hindu Marriage and Divorce Act 1988 came into being with much improvement. Likewise, Christians, they are treated to be the advanced community, but if you look at their matrimonial and other laws, very backward and very poor at that time they were there, but therein also improvement came into being. And then the supreme law of the land, that the Constitution of India, biggest constitution of the whole world, because authors of the Constitution of India, when objective resolution was being prepared by Motilal Nehru, all world constitution, they were studied deeply, taking the contemporary situation and futuristic situation of India for improving too. So that constitution which we are having today, it is not the biggest constitution of India side by side, it is the best constitution of the world. Why? Those people who were involved in authoring the constitution of India, they were very good researchers. They made a very deep research of all progressive countries' constitution, and they made an improvement, and it is improvement reform of the whole constitution, a rather best recognized constitution. Therein, women, all type of salvage, all type of secondary situation, all type of their inferiority, they rejected, and they said women, they are equal. And for that, warn to the government, warn to the executive authorities, even gave the direction to the judiciary that no discrimination on the basis of sex. Women, they are equal. But recognizing and realizing some complex situation which traditionally women they were having, special rights they were also given there, that for women and children, reservation position should be made by there to make them up and up. This is our constitutional mechanism. But one thing, opportunity is there, and I have sought the permission of the chief organizer of this very program, just few conscious situation which women should take care of. That is the feminist movement, and that movement and feminist jurisprudence that is working for the real equality of the male and female. But absolute equality between male and female is not possible, because the nature which is the supreme commander of the situation has not made us male and female equal in absolute term. Somewhere in the corner of the feminist movement, this type of demand is made. Sir, Excellency, I would share with you, I was in China in Beijing conference, and that was on feminism. And there one woman in the midst of the proceeding stood up and said, I am addressing here, I have given a birth of child, and now it is the term of my husband to conceive, to have pregnancy and to give the birth of child. Then absolute equality and real equality which I want, by that my soul is getting satisfaction. Now, learned women, they are here participating in the program. I am sure many, many of you are the award winner. If you are going to be educated like that, this absolute equality which nature has made us different, our mold of personality, our mold of physique, and other things that is separate, purpose of your body, physique, your beauty, your luster, that is for different purpose, and male is for different more. How a male artificially, if it is being educated that male should have the pregnancy and give the birth of the child, is it possible? Absolutely not. So sometime, instead of educating the truth, you are educating the absurdity that is becoming the situation of the mockery. Those who are championing the cause of the women, they should understand, if nature has made in a different way for different purposes, our mutuality, our mixing, our sexuality, our honor, our dignity, that is to be maintained in absolute manner, that should be maintained. Women who are denied their due, whether in the area of politics, whether in the area of education, whether in the area of employment, whether in other areas, lot of areas now open, that must not be allowed to continue for a moment. And for that, I think present government is also very caring. Now, you are witnessing that 3-4 important women, they are the minister, and even a minister, women, who is holding the position of the foreign ministry, defense ministry. Earlier people were, they were talking that just only women they are meant in the military for nursing purpose. Now women they are having different positions. Now they are controlling the plane. Now they are controlling atomic energy. And everywhere they are working, and where they are working, I am sure you are witnessing, they are working with the distinction, with the honor, with the achievement. So, opportunity must be extended in all areas with this assumption that they are capable to do each and everything. And you are doing. World is recognizing. India is recognizing. Yesterday, Ali Garh Muslim University was holding convocation. Our President of India, and along with this, the Governor of Uttar Pradesh, they were there. They witnessed even dominant medal holder population that belong to the female, sir. Female, they got the highest number. And in which area? medicine, engineering, technology, management, law, social sciences, arts. I'm not talking about Yunani Tibia, or I'm not talking about theology. I'm talking advanced discipline. They're winning, they got dominating number of the medals. And they were having full throat appreciation of Aligarh Muslim University's contribution with appreciation. And our Excellency President of India, I said that just few months before I visited Ethiopia by government program, and when we were in the introductory session, Prime Minister, whose wife came forward to me, shook hand, and she said that I did my graduation from Aligarh Muslim University. And he said, anywhere you go, any country you go, just you will be saying the product of Aligarh Muslim University. That is another context that is not here. But I am talking, Aligarh Muslim University is stated to be a traditional university, sir. Their women number was the highest in every field so far as the medal holders are concerned. So I am telling you, you are capable, you are coming up very fastly, lies supporting you. Now, good governance, meaning by the executive authority, by the judiciary, by the legislature, you are being recognized. But please, don't plead for the absurdity, which is not possible. Come up, you educate and flourish. In India, there is a lot of opportunity. This Indo-Nepal organization, under which is this program, Samarsta, under which this award ceremony is being organized. I think this is very good gesture. This is not only for encouragement, rather it is the recognition of your constitutional right. You are inferior to none, you are equally superior, and you can go much if you are determined to achieve your determined target, that on the basis of sex, there is no discrimination, and you are equally entitled for anything for which any male is entitled. I congratulate the organizers of this program. Today, this is International Mahila Divas. On that occasion, this program is being organized, I think most relevant, most good, and such program from time to time should be organized there. Women, whatever distinction they are achieving, for that they should be duly recognized, and they should have this very lesson. Yes, I am equal citizen and part of equal citizenry of this progressive India, which India is now having the world position in terms of the power. And this organization is also determined that this India should get in UN Security Council permanent basis membership with the veto power. You should be the real strength behind this force, which are member of this program is running. Thank you very much, sir.